seed, there is always a place to be rich. Until you be endued. The word here endued means infused. It also means empowered. With power from on high. So there are two definitions of the Holy Ghost in this passage. One is called the promise of the Father, and it's also called power from on high. Can I hear someone say the promise of the Father?
The promise of the Father.
And then?
And the power from on high.
The promise of the Father and power from on high. Now, the word the promise is specified to symbolize the Holy Spirit. So, it is the promise that determines the promises. Did you read my book, The Promise and the Promises? Oh, you came too late. We went to camp. And the team of that camp, the remaining camp, the whole church, was the promise and the promise. And at the end of the day, the book was born. Everything in that book was what happened in the camp. The book is still available. Praise God. We define the Holy Ghost as the promise that enforces every other promise. And God bless them. I said that be fruitful. Multiply. Subdue and take dominion. Those are promises. They can never manifest on their own. Be fruitful. Multiply, subdue, and take dominion. That promises. There will be empty words without the Holy Ghost, God, the promise. The promises of God are powered by the promise. Somebody out here, there's something God has promised you for a long time. I don't know why they are hanging, but when you connect to the promise, you will have the delivery of your promise. And then there's a venture. God is going to relay the anointing. He's going to give you that promise. And you shall manifest your promises. How are we here? How we go well?
Very well.
Praise God. Wake up well. To think well. Have you not had individual whose names are promise? Have you not had it? So it began with God. God named the Holy Ghost promise. So when he comes around you, he announces himself, I am Mr. Promise. And every promise is on your head are now ripe for manifestation.
The promise.
This revelation came after his resurrection. So it's a revelation that came in glory. Okay? It was buried in the swamp, but resurrected in glory. Are we here? And then, and he says, it's a pattern war. It's a final moment. And he said, now my dispensations are over. Behold, I hand over to Mr. Promise. I hand over to Mr. Promise. The dispensation begins now. Behold, I bring you the promise of my Father. This promise of my Father is not coming on you empty. It's coming with power from on high. And it's coming to work to empower you to manifest what I have willed to you. I have willed abundant life to you. I have willed dominion to you. I have willed victory to you. I have willed answers to you. I have willed healing to you.
Yes, the promise.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
Go ahead. Express yourself before Him. The Lord, I bring you the promise of my Father upon you. And that's to show you where the Holy Spirit intends to occupy, to walk through you and in you and for you. Are we here?
Yes, sir.
Just like my son Brown was speaking, I tell my wife, God is the most high God that dwells in the most high heaven and has graciously made me His son. I can't be controlled by what He has given me authority to command. Come on, are we here?
Yes, sir.
I will teach you my wife dominion. I say, see yourself where God has blessed you. See yourself where God expects you to occupy. And stop looking at under. Those that look at under goes under. Those that look up to God retain the height of honor, the rule and the reign everywhere they go. No wonder it's not by power, not by mind, but by my spirit. By my spirit. Someone said, by my spirit.
By my spirit.
Now sit again here. John 14 and verse 16. And I will pray the Father. And He shall give you another Comforter, that He may abide with you forever. A permanent friend, a eternal friend, who will not relate with you according to your height or your weakness or your condition. Whether you have money or not is not important to Him. But He cannot be with you and you are penury. He cannot be with you and you are suffering hardship. He cannot be with you and you are backward. He is your divine helper. Holy Ghost is your helper. It's not important to you than your father. I don't know where your black hair, but I see your help return. When the Holy Ghost return, the rehab will return. When the Holy Ghost return, the rehab will return. I see her return. Now, see verse 17, and we're done. Verse 17 of John 14. Let's take it where it is in the Bible. Even the spirit of truth.
So many destinies have been enslaved and caged by lies,
deception and manipulation. You can't manipulate a true child of God carrying the Holy Ghost.
Examiner.
You can't. Because it's a examiner. Are we here? You will see it. I think yesterday we were talking about divine sensor.
Inducer.
Okay, we have sensor. Sensor is coming. That examiner is a little word for him. The upgraded word now is sensor. Praise God. It goes deeper. You know, now they don't open people to change some things. They use a kind of microscope, you know, tend to dress where the problem is and just put it, and they just go there to pull it out. They don't open you anymore. So the Holy Ghost is no longer committed to physical. How long are you be here? Who put you here? What is your name? Holy Ghost does not operate at that level, this level. Praise God. That's a level it goes. When it goes there, say, I bind you, get out. Even without you speaking, when you appear, the sensor has appeared. A sensor will determine what is wrong and what is right. And it's late, and then, you know, we also have injection and despair of the Holy Ghost. Yes, this is in the manual. You will see them so that your head will be not. Your head will be too hot for nothing. You trouble yourself for nothing, for things that God has handled and documented and handed over to you. You struggle enough to become successful. It is time for you to begin to manifest. So what are we here? Every one of you that have been enslaved and caged by lies, this is your day of liberation. The voice of lies shall go down for yourself. And the voice of truth. It's not a case.
Healer.
Only the methodology is what we don't know. When God heals, and we have to accept that God heals. Do I have anyone can I believe that God heals? Therefore, you shall be healed. It is true that God is interested in the prosperity of the righteous. So even if the devil don't want you to have money, God wants you to have money. And by the grace of God, this convention will answer to you with miracles of money.
Amen.
You shall have money.
Amen.
It is true that God created you male and female, man and woman. And the Bible says that he that is of marriage is a good thing and obtains God's favor. So which people say you will never marry? It is too late. It's a fact. It is a statement of ignorance. Tell the person, he that created me a man and a woman. By the help of the Holy Ghost, as soon as this convention is getting thrown and over, you shall meet your man. You shall meet your woman. It is true to the word of God. In the name of Jesus. It is true that the Bible said that whatever you buy shall be bought. And whatever you lose shall be lose. So no barrier can stand before you. Is there any barrier to any you? I said to you, I command that barrier give way in the name of Jesus. Then he said, even the spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive. The Holy Ghost is not for the world. It's for the church. And if you are in the church and you are in the world, it's not for you. You are religious. The Holy Ghost is not for religious men and women. The Holy Ghost has nothing to do with the world. It does occupy the church. You are not a Christian until there's an experience of the Holy Ghost. Because how can you be carrying God and demons will be commanding you? Controlling you, telling you things that are not of you. He doesn't love me. He hates me. He doesn't do this. I will never forgive you. You are not a Christian yet. You are just coming to church.
You know, I was making a statement in the course of the lockdown. I said, when the lockdown is over, the church status will be redefined. Because the height of transparency of the spirit will be placed in demand for the church. Are we here?
Yes, sir.
Now, go ahead. I said, because it's yet in law, neither knoweth him. So the world does not see him. The world does not know him. And what you don't know, you cannot attract. What you don't know, you cannot relate. What you don't know, you cannot connect.
Yes, sir.
So it's not for the world.
No.
But hear what he said. Do you know him? Someone say, you know him. This 1 week is enough for you to know him, even if you don't know him before. You will have an experience of him.
Yeah.
You will know him. Yeah. Just like you married your wife and you don't know how he looks like.
In diaspora.
Wife online. We call it online marriage. It sounds well, but it lacks value.
Yes, yes.
Because it cannot create value. What can you do online? You are dealing with strangers. Praise God. Somebody build a house, he's building in his father's house. Online marriage. Our relationship with Christ is marriage. The Holy Ghost is the value of the marriage. When you're doing marriage, then the Holy Ghost comes to occupy as a commitment to heaven on your life to go well on the earth. From a book?
No.
I am talking from the Holy Ghost.
Witness.
He is a divine informant. He reveals the deep secrets. He whispers to our ear. Now look at that. For, but you know him. For he dwelleth with you. So there's no distance. Someone that dwells with you, you wake up and say good morning. That's why Long Eto said good morning, Holy Spirit. Why? Because he became so conscious. Holy Ghost, he said, Holy Spirit, let us eat food. As he's watching her, he became so conscious. He doesn't shout like me. But he has such a methodological walk with the Holy Spirit. One of the things lacking that right now we're preaching it, we're conscious of him. After now, you just 10 minutes, you forget. You become yourself. What you don't recognize and value, you cannot connect well. God to walk with you. What? To dwell with you. To dwell with you. Not just to be your church and be your house. To dwell with you. When your toilet is there, when your neighbors is there, when your street is there, when your night is there, is your ever present helper in the hour of your need. He has been given to you by God. It's your responsibility to know that he has been given. And it is now you are right to receive it and to recognize it and to begin to walk with it. The Holy Ghost is looking for recognition in your heart and to connect it in your heart. And then we begin to walk with you. Do I have a witness in the house?
Yes, 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 yes.
Not only that, he also said, shall be in you. So there will be a time. When there's no road and no way, you just see yourself on the other side. Like Peter. Remember the angel came. But the angel was able to walk with Peter and fly with Peter because the Peter was carrying the Holy Ghost inside. Can your car move without an engine? If you have an engine without fuel, can it move?
No.
If you're a Christian, that makes you a mobile automation. And then, if you lack the Holy Spirit, you can't fly far. You can't go far. Now the Bible says, he will also be in you. That means the Bible says, if the same spirit that raised up Christ from the dead dwells in you, are we here? Remember, he dwelleth with you and will also be in you. So he said, he shall be in your water. So it was, first of all, in your inside. And there was in your outside is a present helper is a strength power that has been sent to you by God. When it goes inside, when it goes outside, when it goes in uncle person, when it goes in charge, when it goes, okay, ahead of you, when it goes walking in back on you, rise in your fear and lift up your heart. Whether you are watching in America, whether you are watching in Ghana, whether you are watching in Syria, the Holy Ghost is there. Whether you are watching in Dublin, the Holy Ghost is there. Whether you are watching in Ghana, the Holy Ghost is there. Whether you are watching in Uganda, the Holy Ghost is there.
Every one of us, can we just come and lie on the floor? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Line up this way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, just be praying there. I'm going to say some things right now. For those of you who are in this to you, just be praying. Okay, praise the Lord. It is your reception that will determine his manifestation. A visitor you don't receive is a visitor that you will not entertain. A visitor you will not hear. The Holy Spirit is a divine visitor from heaven. The intent is to perfect your Christian faith, to make the body of your Christianity light, and to bring life to it. I'd like us to worship God in a few minutes. Holy Spirit, move me now.
Holy Spirit, move me now. Make my life whole again. Spirit move.
Spirit move.
I praise you.
Let's see now, planted material.